Have you ever experienced a moment like this? You've joined a video conference over Wi-Fi, but cannot hear the other people clearly. You try for some time to resolve it, but end up having to leave and rejoin the video conference anyway. You may wonder why Wi-Fi, having improved over many years, cannot offer audio and video services on a par with wired networks. There are three main reasons. Firstly, bandwidth has increased, and so have the demands for it. This is similar to today's wider-than-ever highways, where traffic is still congested during holidays. Secondly, traffic bursts and user mobility often occur on wireless networks. Users sometimes gather like a swarm of bees, congesting an area. Thirdly, one user exclusively occupies one Ethernet cable on wired networks. In contrast, users contend for air interface resources on wireless networks. In high-density user environments, when congestion occurs, how can we ensure smooth user experience for key services? The wired part on a campus network functions like arterial roads, while the wireless part works like on-off ramps. Too many vehicles on the same ramps cause congestion and even paralyze arterial roads. Similarly, packet loss occurs in case of congestion on the campus network. How can we prevent packet loss? We need a switch with a large buffer, which works in a similar way to diverting vehicles into highway service areas. We can set a large buffer value to temporarily store data packets. This is large buffer design. For latency-sensitive applications, akin to police cars and ambulances on roads, we can prioritize lanes on the network to preferentially ensure key services. This is QoS. However, when all users in a conference room concurrently access a video, QoS becomes ineffective. In this case, we need to consider both application and user types and divide lanes into sublanes. This new approach ensures smooth user experience from telepresence terminals. We call it HQoS technology. Users on wireless networks contend for resources, meaning no lanes on ramps. Facing this, Wi-Fi 6 introduces OFDMA technology that divides the air interface into subcarriers. In this way, some subcarriers can be reserved for VIPs. This means dedicated lanes are set up on wireless networks. Ordinary users can use these lanes if there are no VIPs. If VIPs appear, they are the ones who use these lanes. This technology is called VIP bandwidth reservation. By using technologies across wired and wireless networks, including a large buffer, HQoS, and VIP bandwidth reservation, the smooth experience of key services can be assured in case of congestion. This is Huawei's intelligent HQoS technology. For details, visit Huawei's Cloud Campus 2.0 solution website and download the intelligent HQoS white paper.